Okay, gloomy weather today with the rain and all, but what good news! Just when you thought nothing else was gonna happen for the end of the year, huh? This does. And unfortunately, I can't talk about it. Stupid NDAs, they ruin all the fun. This will actually be a first for me, and it's too bad I can't document it a lot better. It's just, again, they basically gag you from saying anything usually. Well, we'll see how this goes. It should be happening possibly within the next week or so. As usual, one day at a time, like for most things, and like I said before, when great things happen, I guess in one aspect of life, that basically means better things in everything else too. And some brief updates about the SFOC stuff. Essentially, there's this little section that says, what is your detect and avoid, I guess, kind of hardware and stuff that you're using, which made me a little unclear. Like for example, for detect and avoid, do you specifically mean things to keep track of other planes, that planes keep track of you? Do you mean obstacle sensors? So the person that gave me the contact, the number was like in Ottawa. Tried phoning a bunch of times, no answer. Researched it online, I think I had the right guy email them, no answer. So at this point, I just submitted basically like a huge document of my plan and so forth, again, based on the checklist. So we'll see how it goes. I guess with detecting things in the air, that seemed to be a theme with the stuff I read today. Let's look at this first unfortunate one. It says, multiple deaths reported after plane crashes on Northern Gabriola Island, BC. It's just near here, actually. Emergency crews have descended in force on the north end of Gabriola Island, BC, where a small plane crashed Tuesday evening. RCMP members who traveled to the scene confirmed multiple fatalities on the island near Nanaimo. BC Emergency Health Services said no one was taken to hospital and that both the size of the airplane and the number of passengers on board was still unclear. And I guess some of the witnesses basically described, like they heard the plane and stuff, it says it was really, really loud, like almost shaking my house. And then I heard it crash. It was the loudest crash I ever heard. And then one person said they heard an explosion after crash but was unable to see the actual site crash through the trees. So currently, I guess it's still unknown what exactly happened. I guess what was interesting too was how a lot of news report agencies are trying to discover what happened with the plane by using like some apps and stuff that show you, I guess, the air traffic like in real time. And I guess some of them are pre-recorded and they can show you like the plane basically for some reason. I guess it looked like it started to spin and all that. And that's actually related to some of the SFOC stuff because they ask you, for example, is there a way, I guess, your drone can be tracked by other aircraft and all that? So it's interesting reading this one in terms of drone IDs and stuff. It says, major remote ID drone tracking system standard to be published by ASTM International. So will there be a standard for things like drone ID and stuff like that? Maybe. I mean, according to this, it says, a highly anticipated ASTM International standard aims to satisfy the growing demand for better identification and tracking of unmanned aircraft systems, commonly known as drones in the airspace worldwide. Similar to the function of a car license plate, the remote ID standard supports technology that allows the general public and public safety officials to identify a drone using an assigned ID while preserving privacy of the operator's personal identifiable information. The robust standard, to be published in the coming weeks with the designation F3411, was developed by the ASTM International Unmanned Aircraft Systems Committee. This actually makes me wonder if it's that open drone ID, like that Bluetooth thing, because it says, according to Gabriel Cox, drone systems architect at Intel, the new specification outlines how drones will transmit the assigned ID, location, speed, and direction by broadcasting over the air and or sending over a wireless internet connection to a UAS service supplier. Saying, quote, a receiver could be a common smartphone that would be able to associate the ID with the location of the drone. So yeah, it makes you wonder if it is that open drone ID thing. And it says, this new standard is yet another example of how technical standards are crucial to driving innovation on a global scale. I guess it's good to have something universal like that. At the same time, it'll be good to have universal, I guess, recognizable laws where everything will be the same thing for the most part. In saying that though, hopefully there will be a clear distinction between, for example, someone flying the drone recreationally for fun just to capture basic video and footage versus companies using it to do deliveries and all that, because there has to be a distinction. Because in terms of like things like innovation and all that, you have to let people use it, basically. Like if they're doing it in a perfectly safe way to innovate, even if it's a kid that's just curious about the tech. Another rainy day stopping that drone flights, I guess. Huh, I guess it's time for the archive. All right. See you guys later.